Hello everyone, my name is Chris and I am here with the new Wily Fox Spark. So if you haven't heard of Wily Fox before, it's a British brand. Last year they came out with two smartphones, the Swift and the Storm. We've got the Swift here. It's a cheap and cheerful little £129 mobile phone, 5-incher, and it boasts CyanogenOS, which is one of its more sort of standout features. And again, Wily Fox is back in 2016 with three new phones. The Spark is the cheapest one. This is an £89 Cyanogen phone again. So that makes it one of the cheapest smartphones we've actually seen in 2016. We've seen a couple of other cheap ones from Vodafone and the Honor, but this is definitely the cheapest that we've played with personally. So £89, and you also get a Spark Plus and a Spark X, which I will explain later. So this is, as I say, the most affordable one. It comes in this lovely orange box with this gorgeous... It seems it's almost a shame to unbox it, really, because it's so bloody lovely. But unbox it we shall, otherwise this will be a really short and crap video instead of just a long and crap video. So just peel back this sticker and we'll be able to dive right in. Void. So there you go. Love the orange boxes. Exactly the same as last year's efforts. And here we go. Here is our first glimpse of the Wily Fox Spark. So as you can see, first off, of course, not massively different from last year's Swift and last year's Storm as well. You can see it's a nice textured back in there. It's fully black. There will be almost certainly a white model and hopefully some other colours as well. But, you know, wishful thinking probably. See the Wily Fox logo on the back there, which is definitely one of the coolest logos around. Nice fox head there. Very sleek. Got an 8 megapixel camera up at the top there and a single LED flash. Little speaker grill at the bottom there, and of course the Wily Fox branding. So you can see it's a slightly chunky phone, not overly so. Probably about the same as the likes of the Moto G4. Got the volume rocker on the left-hand side here. Down at the bottom, got the old-school USB port there. And on the right-hand side, you've got the power button. And then up top, headphone jack. Nice and simple and straightforward. Looks like there's a screen protector thing on it as well, because there's a bit of bubble in there. So let's just try and get that off too. There we go. Peel that bad boy off. Put that way. And let's see. Hopefully there's some charge in it. Actually, it feels like maybe the battery isn't even inside it. So let's just prise it open and have a little gander inside. Aha! Didn't fall for it this time. Wily Fox. So let's remove all this and see if we can actually find the battery somewhere in the box. So here you go, there's the battery in all its glory, in this little pouch. Let's rip that out. So as you can see as well, and from the back of the Wily Fox there, it's a dual SIM device, two SIM cards, and you've also got micro SD storage in order to expand the 8 GB, rather measly amount of onboard storage. For £89, what do you expect, right? So let's just slot that back on there. And there you go, so you've got a bit more heft to it now, and let's see if it turns on. Hopefully it'll already be partially charged. Yes, nice little rumble, that's what we like. Wily Fox, powered by Android. So as you can see, of course, it is a Cyanogen phone, so it's running Android 6.0 Marshmallow, but it's also running Cyanogen 13 on top of that, which is nice. So here's a nice little pictorial guide on how to charge the thing, etc., etc. All the stuff I just said, basically. Way ahead of you, Wily Fox, safety and warranty, blah, blah, blah. Usual stuff, lots of different languages, which you won't need soon because obviously we've just given Europe the finger, hooray. But this isn't the time for politics, is it, kiddies? It's time for unboxings. So here we go, nice old school USB, not Type C sadly, but of course it's a cheap phone, so not really surprised, as you can see there. Cyanogen, da da! So let's pop that back in the box. That's about as exciting as that gets. No headphones or anything like that. But again, for the price, what do you expect? The moon on a stick. So pop all that away and out of the way. And a little bit more about the phone itself. So as I say, it's £89, 5-inch, 720p screen there. So hopefully, like last year's Swift, it'll be a nice, as you can see, it's quite nice and crisp still. I think it's about 290-ish pixels per inch, so you shouldn't really have much trouble at all actually making out stuff. I can't see any individual pixels, just looking really close there. So what I'm going to do is we're going to zip through the setup process and hopefully have a good play around with the phone's interface. So that doesn't look like there's any support for 5 GHz Wi-Fi, so this setup process is probably gonna take a while, so we'll just cut away with a whizzy effect. Ooh. Right, literally just logged into Cyanogen and Wi-Fi and all that other bollocks, and now we are here. So this is the Wiley Fox Spark, Cyanogen 13 on top of Android Marshmallow. Looks like it's still taking its little time, just getting everything set up. I've got to admit, I have seen a few little sort of stutters during the setup process. Hopefully it'll start to calm down a bit, but it's MediaTek MT6735 processor, so pretty budget as you'd expect again for the price, with just 1 GB of RAM as well. So I am expecting to see the odd stutter, but you know, see how it goes. You know, give it fair play. Fingers crossed it won't be too bad. So as you can see there, reasonably smooth into the Cyanogen apps tray. As you can see, everything's nicely ordered by the alphabet. A little bit more about Cyanogen. As I say, it basically sits on top of Android OS and adds a few extra bonus features, mostly to do with security and customization. So it does look like Android at first glance and everything. As you see, notifications tray, not too dissimilar. You've got your usual shortcuts and all the rest. Screen brightness slider, which doesn't seem to do anything. Okay, fair play. See what's going on there. Settings, we dive into that. Then we can have a bit of a plan here as well. So as I say, dual SIM card setup. I haven't put any SIMs in yet, but that's quite handy if you've got a work SIM and a home SIM, for instance. Dive into there. You've got some more various data settings. Again, not hugely responsive. So if we go into the display, then as you see here, you've got adaptive brightness, which is always nice to have. Live display as well. You can actually have it customize itself depending on the not just the time, but also the overall environmental conditions. So if it's at night, it can dim down a bit. Hopefully it'll make the colors a bit warmer as well, so it's less disturbing for anyone else who might be in your bed with you. Lucky them. Got the likes of tap to wake and other gesture stuff as well. So if we turn the phone off by pressing that, again, bit of a delay. We should hopefully do a double tap. There we go, second time lucky. And all the rest of it as well, yes. There's plenty of likes of Daydream and other stuff like that. LCD density, that's an interesting one. So it looks like you can actually configure the density of the screen as well. Interesting. And of course, you've got notification light and everything as well. So if we give that a tap, you can have a bit of a play with that, see whether the screen should go on with notifications, etc., etc. as well. If we dive back out of there, and then we go into themes as well. Themes is a big thing for Cyanogen. Don't know what's going on there. Again, not the most. Hang on a sec. I'll just give the screen a quick wipe in case it's my greasy fingers that's screwing it all up. Oh, I don't know what it's doing now. I think I've just. Oh, yeah. Rubbing it against my nipples seems to have confused it a little bit. Sorry, phone. Didn't mean to do that. Back into settings, and if we go down to, as I say, themes, you can completely configure. So Wiley Fox has actually got its own theme there, but you can customize it yourself. So you can change any of the icons, basically. You can mix and match with different themes. Go into settings, as you can see, change the icons, navigation, the fonts, ringtone, all that kind of stuff. Even the boot animation, excuse me. Oh, excuse me, dear God. I'm sorry, my stomach's not 100% today. I do apologize for my uncouth behavior. And as you can see, go into shop themes and you can actually download some more stuff from the internet, which is always nice. As I say, it's not support for 5 GHz Wi-Fi, so it will be a little slow because I haven't actually slotted in a SIM card just yet. And our Wi-Fi isn't the best. But yeah, you get a good selection of stuff in there. So as I say, you can change the icons at the bottom, icons of any of the apps, the wallpaper, all the rest of it, get it looking just the way you want it. It's just popping up as I press leave there, never mind. So what else is there to see? Cameras, of course, yes. So if we go into the camera stuff, down here at the bottom, you have an 8-megapixel camera on the back there, and you also get an 8-megapixel camera on the front. So if we go yes, you can see the Wiley Fox camera app is it's quite nice and streamlined, very easy to use. So as you can see, it's on full auto mode at the moment. It's got full autofocus, so you can, as you see, if you move it around, it reconfigures, and you can also give it a quick tap to manually focus as well. If you want to focus on near ground or far ground, that's all good. And then you just hit that button there to take a shot. And if we Try doing different focus. It looks like it takes shots pretty quickly. So that's good. Yep, that's very responsive, so that's always good to see. You've also got panorama mode and of course video mode. I believe you can shoot full HD video at 30 frames per second. So that's a match for the likes of the Moto G4. We'll be putting up a video sample pretty much as soon as this goes live. So stay tuned for that. There we go. Bit of a delay in swapping to video modes, but we got there in the end. And can you manually? Yep, you can manually focus in videos, so that's always good as well. If you're moving around and shooting at the same time, for instance. So let's just call a halt to that. Stop. And hopefully it should switch back into photo mode. And as you can see as well, you can of course pause the video rather than just straight out stopping it, which is always handy if you need to do a bit of setup or something. So back into the standard camera app again. Takes a while to get there, but to be fair to the phone, it is still in the process of setting up in the background. So I will obviously be using it as my full-time phone for a good few days. And I will get back to you with a full review to see how the performance is in general. You've got you could also cycle through the different flash modes, of course. You've got full manual settings if you do want to Full manual mode in case you want to fiddle around with the different settings. So you've got different modes here. Sunny mode, it's a bit cloudy. There you go, that just deals with that, etc, etc. So if you do want to play around with it, you're not quite happy with how auto mode's working out, that's all good. And if you go into the settings, as you can see, it's currently on 8 megapixel mode, which is the highest. So let's cancel that. You've got the video quality and everything. Burst mode is also an option, so that's nice. As I say, the lens does seem nice and nippy, which is always good. And yep, touch focus, face detection, and all the rest of it as well. So your standard sort of camera mode, swap to video. Let's see, a 1080p HD, you can also shoot in 720 and the rest if you want to down the quality a bit in order to save a bit of space. As I say, there's only 8 gigabytes of storage on here, and but at least there's that micro SD memory card slot, so you can boost by another 32 if needed. And then you've got other things as well. You can select to take a photo with the various buttons, for instance, swap the controls around if you're left-handed, etc. So that's all nice to have. So in terms of the actual camera app itself, seems really nice. The camera seems quite nippy apart from when you're actually swapping to video mode. So we'll be doing a full camera review and everything as well, see how that all turns out. I am tapping the home button. I'm feeling a vibration, but not doing anything. There we go. Right, so that in a nutshell, is the Wiley Fox Spark. It is a sparky little number. Hopefully those performance issues will sort themselves out. It's starting to get a little bit toasty at the on the back here, just at the top as well. I guess that's where all the processor and everything is. Again, might just be the setup process. The Xperia XA was exactly the same during setup, and then it was nice and cool after that. So, fingers crossed. And I think the only other thing I did mention was 2200 milliamp battery inside of it as well, which of course, as you saw, is fully removable, which is nice. So if you've got any questions at all, or want us to talk about anything in particular, let us know in the comments below, and stay tuned for full review and the rest. Thanks for watching, everyone. Bye.